It's time for Hee-Haw!
Welcome to Hee-Haw! With special guests Roger Miller, Peggy Little, and Yankee star Bobby Mercer, and starring Buck Owens and Roy!
From Buffalo down to Tennessee.
From St. Louis Mo up to OBC.
The hee-haw fun is set to fly.
Hey, Roy, we got through it.
My, oh, my.
Right now!
I'm sorry, Gina, but my feelings have changed. I'm breaking our engagement.
Well, give me back my ring.
Oh, no. It's my feelings towards you that have changed. I still feel the same for the ring.
Junior Samples is the Rudolph Valentino of his day.
Must be a lousy day.
Hey, Arch, I guess you heard the joke about the sky.
No, I don't think I have.
Well, it's just as well it's over your head.
Say, how come your dog's so smart? I can't learn mine no tricks at all.
Well, Junior, the first thing is, you have to know more than the dog.
Oh, I don't think I got that one.
You see, the thing is, the dog's smart. It's Junior that's dumb.
I heard someone say your brother can't work without liquor.
That's right. He's a bartender.
Hey, I hear the teachers are trying to stop the kissing in school.
Boy, the next thing you'll know, they'll want the students to stop, too.
I bet this group is banned in Boston.
My wife is... Boy, my wife is diabetically.
I never say the word like that.
Roy, my wife is diabolic. Yes. My wife is diabetically cunning.
Oh, yeah? How come?
Because she figured out what I'm going to be before I do, what I'm going to do before I done it. You know, Roy, my wife is diabolically cunning.
Oh, yeah? How come?
Because she figures out what I'm going to do before I do it.
Why don't we drop into the living room right now? Because Buck and the gang are having a time.
Oh, the sun's gonna shine in my life once more.
Love's gonna live here again.
Things are gonna be the way they were before.
Love's gonna live here.
Yeah.
Bobby Mercer.
Hooray!
Hi, Bobby.
Hi.
I understand you're a Yankee.
Only in the summertime.
What are you in the wintertime?
Cold.
Hey, Doc, it hurts when I do that.
Well, don't do that. Doc, it hurts when I do this. Well, don't do that.
Doc, it really hurts when I do this, you know?
Do that again.
Hee-haw is the happiest show on television.
You know, Roy, my boy sure saved me some money this year.
He quit college so you don't have to buy him books, huh?
No, he's being held over in the same class for another year, so he'll use the same one.
Hey, did you hear the one about the guy that was looking for the gas leak with a lighted match?
No! What happened?
People 10 miles away heard him find it.
And the next 30 seconds of Hee Haw is brought to you by Junior Samples Used Car Sales.
Hi, friends, cousins, gentle in public, and the car buying public. I've got a great little foreign car for sale. It's in machine shop right now. They're trying to find out what it is. This little job is so small, it's only got 2 seats. It's made like a right nice car for one guy that's 4'6", or for a man that's only got one friend. The number to call is BR549.
The trouble with those little bucket seats is that we all ain't got the same size bucket.
Jollyville, North Carolina. Population 2.
Come here, Mr. Mercer. Would you teach me some baseball talk?
He's a large child.
Come here, Mr. Mercer.
So much since my sister Elva backed into the potted ferns with the silver tea service.
Come here, Mr. Mercer. Would you teach me some baseball talk?
Control yourself, Bobby. Junior's contagious.
Come here, Mr. Mercer. Could you teach me some baseball talk?
Sure, Junior.
Squeeze me there.
We've lost control.
I added that down. You hadn't lied.
Junior just struck out Bobby Mercer. But he'll get another chance later, darn Yankee.
Trailers for sale or rent. Rooms to let 50 cents. He's a man.
Mr. Miller.
Oh, boy.
Well, here I sit high getting ideas. Ain't nothing but a fool to live like this. Out all night and running wild. A woman sitting home with a month-old child. Dang me, dang me. They ought to take a rope and hang me. High from the highest tree. Woman, would you weep for me? You got that, Junior? Fantastic. Wow. We're sitting around drinking with the rest of the guys. Six rounds bought and I bought five. Spent the groceries and half the rent. I like $14.27. So dang me, dang me. They ought to take a rope and hang me. High from the highest tree. Woman, would you weep for me? One more time. Purple and sugar's sweet and so's maple syrup. And I'm the seventh out of seven sons. My pappy's pistol, I'm a son of a gun. And dang me, dang me. They ought to take a rope and hang me. High from the highest tree. Woman, would you weep for me?
The ice cream cone was invented by Ferdinand Whippet in 1894. Now, he didn't know what to do with it, so he sat on it, causing it to lose a great deal of its value.
Bum diddle bum.
Mildred, have you heard about Lizzie Tinkham? She had her face lifted. I think they kind of overdone it. Every time she blinks her eyes, she pulls her stockings up.
My old friend Peter Muse used to sit in front of a mirror for hours on end and contemplate a mole on his nose. But no matter how hard he stared, the mole never went away. The same can be said for his nose.
What's that supposed to mean?
I said it last week, and it was a hit.
So is this.
Mercer, could you teach me some no-ball?
Sometimes that Junior is just as comical as a trick mule.
And for those of you who are not completely satisfied with tonight's show, simply return the unused portion of the show, and we'll return your time. But just tear off the top of your head and send it in with 19 school children under the age of 6.
Junior, isn't there anything about the fact that I'm crazy about you that pleases you?
Yes, I mar your taste.
I just don't understand why you're always avoiding me.
It's because I see a lot of fellers who let some girl get them under their thumb. And once that happened, they commence to wiggle like a worm. And not long after that, the chicken gets them.
I've read all sorts of things about a fool in love, but not a word about loving a fool.
Broke the clock because I wound it up too tight. Lucky me, I didn't sleep a wink last night. I was up on time to do what I must do. I wish I didn't have to miss you. Wonder whose glasses that I'm seeing through, because I'm seeing When it's Sunday, it'll be Sunday day and night. Red is red, black is black, and blue is blue. I wish I didn't have to miss you.
Just as sweet as a paddle of bass with honey. And when she sings, she sure touches both ends of the rainbow.
Come here, Mr. Mercer. Will you teach me some baseball talk?
Sure, Junior.
Okay, what's a squeeze play?
That's when you and Lulu try to get into the same car.
One more line like that, and I'm gonna bench you for the rest of the show.
Is that it?
Lead a horse to water, but if you can teach him to roll over and float on his back, you got something.
Here's your KORN reporter with all the latest births, marriages, and bereavements. Them has been hatched, matched, or snatched. Now, first, your birth. Mr. and Mrs. Holeb Clotworthy has a new baby. Well, did you ever hear of anybody having an old baby? We asked Hole what he was going to call the new one. And he said him and his wife had decided to call it quits. I'll tell you why. This here is number three, and Mrs. Clotworthy read in the Breeder's Digest that from now on, every fourth child born in the world is going to be Chinese. And here's for your wedding bells. Pitt Fessenden finally got married. Gol, he's been turned down more times than a bedspread. The lucky girl is Duddy Flicker. By hinkus, I've known her since she was two-thirds the size of a pint dipper. You mind that she was the youngest of the litter. Duddy, she was the last flicker on her father's side. Well, sir, Pitt and Duddy got married last week. And yesterday, they had a couple of little strangers come to stay with them. Her mother and father. The funny thing is that Pitt had planned to move in on his folks, but he had to give up the ID because his folks are still living with their folks. Last but not your least, the rest in your peace department. Fleming Dunbar. Oh, my God, isn't that a caution? I tell you, there's people kicking the bucket these days that never done it before. Fleming Dunbar has passed over at the tender age of 86. The cause of death is unknown because old Flem, he didn't believe in doctors. He used to treat himself out of one of them handy home doctor yourself books. Coronary's report says that he could have died of a misprint. Now, his widow, you mind Eulalie? His widow was seen at the funeral wearing a 14-carat sparkly ring. She says Flem left her $3,000 to get a nice stone in his memory, and Eulalie picked out a genuine star sapphire.
Huh?
understand old Clem put a bathtub in his house.
Yep, he says every night after dinner his wife sits in the bathtub.
That's a good idea. She can take a bath and wash your dishes at the same time.
Grandpa, Lulu, and Cousin Clem have been in the hands of kidnappers for 3 weeks now. And today, Junior is visited by Inspector Crumwell, head of the Brewster Center Bureau of Investigation.
Now, Junior, I'll need an accurate description of the kidnappers. Now, how many was there?
Between 2 and 10.
Could you get a little closer than that?
All right, between 1 and 5.
That's close enough. Now, what did they look like?
Well, they awful-looking people. Their noses was all squares down, their mouth was all crooked and funny, and their hair was all mashed down.
People like that ought to be real easy to find. Anything else?
Yes, they wore silk stockings over their head.
Well, that'll make it even easier. Don't worry, Junior, I'll find them. It's been my experience that professional kidnappers always go to places you'd least expect to find them. And I think I know exactly where they are.
Where?
Acapulco. And I'm leaving today. I'll be half detective and I'll be half on vacation. See you in 2 months. Ole, Junior!
Tune in next time when we hear Junior say...
Dear Inspector Crumwell, I forgot to tell you, don't drink the water.
I'm from Texas, and everybody I know has got at least one oil well. Why, we've even got an oil well on our farm that produces over 400 barrels a day. No oil, just barrels.
Here are the Hagers.
You who are on the road must have a code that you can live by. And so become yourself, because the past is just a goodbye. Teach your children well, their father's hell is slowly going by. And lead them on dreams, the one they pick, the one you'll know by. Don't you ever ask them why, if they told you you would cry. So just look at them and sigh. And know they love you. Of tender years can't know the fears that your elders grew by. So please help them with your youth. They see the truth before they can die. Teach your parents well, their children's hell will slowly go by. And feed them on your dreams, you'll know by. Don't you ever ask them why, if they told you you would cry. Just look at them and sigh. And know they love you. And know they love you.
I heard tell that due to a recent Supreme Court decision, C-sharp minors are not allowed in musical bars.
1, 2, 3, 4. Ha, 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 ha
Would you autograph my baseball?
Virginia, that's a basketball.
It is. No wonder I can't strike nobody out.
Here's our own singing group, the Nashville Edition.
Ticket stand that you changed your mind. Let me run on out and tell the cab to keep his meter flying. 'Cause if you say goodbye to me, babe, you're gonna break my mind. Break my mind. Take your suitcase off of those scales in time.
Tell the man that I suddenly developed a thing about flying. 'Cause if you say goodbye to me, babe, you're gonna break my mind.
I know I don't look like it, but I'm really good looking. I think I resemble that remark.
Now here's KORN's special report on crop rotation with Samuel B. Sternwheeler.
I look a person, and right away I know if he's a friend or an enemy. But when I look at a caterpillar, I'm never quite sure. So therefore, I rarely invite a caterpillar to my home.
That makes me mad. There ain't much makes me mad, but that makes me so mad I could swallow bullfrogs backwards.
Isn't it just terrible for a man to love you and leave you?
Not if he leaves you enough.
Oh, my dear. What words can I say that will make you mine?
$1 million.
Here's Roy Clark.
I might have been a hopeless soul with nothing much in store. I might have been without a goal, just dreams and nothing more. I might have known a life alone, but that's where you came in. Your loving arms have saved me from the things I might have been. I might have been
stranger everywhere. Or one of those, or stay at home with no one's lips to share. But your sweet kiss has changed all this and made my life begin. Keep loving me. Don't ever let me be the things I might have been. I might have been.
I might have been.
And just think, girls. He's exactly 6 feet tall. Wouldn't that make a couple of nice yards around your house?
It takes a big man to whip me. Don't take him long, though.
Here's one of my favorite spots in the show. Buck and Roy and Pickin' and Grinnin'.
Did you hear about the Eskimo who got stabbed with an icicle?
No.
Poor fella, he died of cold cuts.
That didn't come over on the art.
For just a minute.
Looks like you already had.
Yeah. I got a chicken joke.
Oh, good. We're voting for that. We believe it.
Why did the chicken wear red suspenders?
Golly, I don't know. Do you, Roy?
I don't know, Roy.
To keep up the payments on his coup. No.
You better sing another one.
Wouldn't that put your tail up over your back?
Oh. If Edison hadn't invented the electric light, we'd be sitting around today watching TV by candlelight.
Isn't Junior wonderful?
I'm not certain, but I believe this show is a little bit off-center.
Morning there, Gordy.
Hello, Charlie.
Junior. Cold enough already.
Mm-hmm. Archie. Howdy, Charlie. Could I interest you in a shave?
I beg your pardon.
Could I interest you in a shave?
Well, I haven't got time to take the hat off, so maybe I'll have one. How much do you charge for a shave?
Shave's 25 cents cash.
Would you sandpaper me for a dime? Why I asked that. Roy Clark, he was in here last time, and he makes Archie pay him a nickel every time he cuts him, you know. Well, Roy come away with quite a pile of money. He says Archie's the town cut-up. How's the family, Arch?
Well, I'm glad you asked. My poor old wife's in the hospital.
No.
Yeah, she's got double petunia.
You mean pneumonia? Petunia is a flower like a begonia.
No. He makes up a begonia is like something you make sandwiches with. You know, like a big old, nothing like a good begonia sandwich. You know? Sliced tomatoes and a little salt.
No salt. It's like when you hit someone. Salt's a crime.
No, crime is like when you climb up to the top of a mountain, you know, crime a tree.
You're thinking about tree like 1-2 tree. And the tree's a crowd, and a crowd makes a lot of noise.
No, a noise is like something in the middle of your face, right between your eyes. Like, that's a noise.
That's a moon. That's where you usually catch a cold.
No, you mixed up. A cold is a little baby horse.
A
horse is when you catch a cold and can't talk good, and you have to go to bed because you're hoarse.
That's exactly what I said. I said, my wife caught a little cold, cold as a little horse, so we sent her to the hospital, and I think you ought to send her some flowers.
Why?
Because she's got double petunia.
Peggy Little.
Statue of a fool made of stone, an image of a man who let love slip through his hands and then just let him stand there.
Hee-haw salutes Miller Falls, population 1. Make that 0. The next 30 seconds of Hee-haw is brought to you by Junior Samples Used Car Sales.
Hi, folks. Junior Samples here, owner and general manager of Samples Sales. We have a huge selection of used cars.
There's Roger Miller.
Did you ever feel unwanted, kicked around so much you're taunted, heart cried out from so much pain? Well, that's the way I feel. I loved someone and loved her dearly, spoke sweet words, she didn't hear me, left me here heart sick and lonely. That's the way I feel. To cry would do no good, I used to think it would, but the more I cried, the more I believed. Here's what I'll do. Let this feeling have its day, maybe it will go away, maybe I will find another. That's the way I feel. Can't let heartbreak overcome me just because of the way she done me. I'll forget I ever loved her. That's the way I feel. Oh, buddy, I'm a... Yeah.
think it would. But the more I cried, the more I believed, here's what I'll do. I'll just let this feeling have its day. Maybe it will go away. Maybe I will find another, that's the way I feel. I can't let heartbreak overcome me just because of the way she done me. I'll forget I ever loved her, that's the way I feel. Yes, I'll forget I ever loved her, that's the way I feel.
Charlie Ferguson with the KORN sudden announcement. It's an invitation for you one and your all to hustle over to the Russell Dildock Farm tonight for a surprise fowl supper, euchre and dance. It's only $1.25 a plate, with all the proceedings going toward the building of Russell's new hen house. Now, I'll tell you why all this has come up so all of a sudden. Last night, about 2 o'clock in the morning, old Russ, he heard an uncommon lot of clucking out there in the Dildock hen house. Well, he figured on chicken thieves. So he quick grabbed his shotgun and went out of the house in nothing but his long johns, followed 2 paces behind by his faithful bird dog, Blue Nose the Second. Well, sir, when Russell and the dog got there, the hen house door was wide open. So Russ, he stopped to cock his gun, but the dog didn't, came right on coming. So before you could say Jack Robinson, that shotgun went off all by itself. Well, sir, when the smoke cleared away, the hen house was a wreck, and there was quite a score. 43 dead chickens just from one dog's cold nose. So there'll be a sit-down supper for 75 tonight at the Dildock Farm. And the next time, I think old Russ will remember to keep his trap shut.
Yes, sir, I very near went to the President's White House ball the other night.
How near, Buck?
Well, I wanted to go, but I didn't get invited. Oh.
You mean tell me that you and your wife never had a disagreement at all?
No, sirree. She's worked out a foolproof arrangement.
Is that?
It's like a plan. In the morning, she does what she wants to do, and in the afternoons, I do what she wants to do. And the night, she takes me bowling, but my head's getting sore.
Say, Lulu, how come you going around telling everybody I look like a dumb bunny?
That's a lie. You don't look nothing like a bunny.
That's different. Use your brain, Junior. It's the little things that count.
That's for...
Don't you and your wife ever have a difference of opinion?
Sure we do. I just don't tell her about it.
You know, Ma says Pa talks in his sleep. I wonder why he does that. Well, Pa says it's because he doesn't want to forget how.
I once kissed a Polynesian girl.
Really? What did she say?
She said she longed for some more. That one, ball two. You're safe. You're out.
What are you doing, Junior?
Practicing to be umpire.
Well, you'll need these.
I could have Junior all to myself. All I need is for Lula to get drafted.
Buck Owens.
We'll be right back.
Remember the golden rule. It's about that long.
From all of us to all of you, till we meet again, may your skies be blue, may your days be bright, may your thoughts be light, till we meet again.
We'll see you next week
right here on
Hee-Haw!
In the Nashville edition.
Also, next week,
special guests Tom T. Hall, Dee Dee Shepherd, and Janella Hutton-Swain.